हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू मनु लॉ क्लासेस। आई एम गौतम दीक्षित, सब्जेक्ट मैटर एक्सपर्ट, जीके एंड करंट अफेयर्स। टुडे इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस द इम्पॉर्टेंट करंट इवेंट्स ऑफ पास्ट वन वीक फ्रॉम 12th June to 18th June 2021। सो द कंटेंट विच वी आर गोइंग टू सी टुडे इज डीप ओशियन मिशन, इट्स इम्पॉर्टेंस फॉर इंडिया एंड वाई इंडिया इज गोइंग फॉर दिस मिशन नाउ ओनली एंड हाउ इट इज गोइंग टू हेल्प इंडिया। Then we will see at ASEAN Defense Ministers Meet Plus, what are the issues which is going on in Southeast Asia and how it is going to influence India and how India is influenced by it and what are the probable solutions. Then we will study the Indo-Pacific region and what are the strategies which India has adopted at national, regional and global level to counter the Chinese influence in this region. Then we will look at SAGR. Then we will also discuss about the state of the economy report by RBI, which was recently released, and it discusses that what are the state of the economy, what the challenges it is going to face, and what are the situation in which the government needs to pump up the economy. And then we are going to look at a new variant which has been discussed, AOI.1, and then we will look at more topics which we are going to discuss today in a question and answer format. Before I start, my friend, we at Manu Law Classes, we have already launched 1 year and 2 year course, so you can enroll today by calling us at 9971444054, or you can visit us at www.lawentranceindia.com and you can inquire about these batches. So don't wait for the lockdown to get lifted and then start your studying. Be an early bird and chase your dream at early speed. Then for your benefits, we have come up with a unique concept. We call it as a free trial. It is a 15-day free trial. So here you will have access to live classes with one-to-one interaction, access to recorded conceptual lectures on various topic and sectional test, and the analysis of those tests based on your performance. Okay, so you will have access to all these 5 features. Now how to enroll in the free trial? So it is very easy. Go in the description box. You will find a link, click on that link, fill the form, and you are set for the 15-day trials. So the first topic is deep ocean mission. So first of all, let us understand what is deep ocean. Okay, deep ocean is something which is very deep, just above the floor of the ocean. So suppose this is the floor of the ocean. Okay, fine. So just above the floor of the ocean, we call it deep sea. It is about 6,000 fathom. 1 fathom is equal to 6 feet. 6,000 fathom below the ocean surface, we call this region as deep sea. Okay, now you must be wondering that why we are interested in deep sea. Deep sea mein aisa kya hai ki hum usko explore hame karna chahiye? To thoda sa hum uske bare mein discuss kar lete hain. Okay, so see, one of the most fundamental importance of deep sea is that it is a large reservoir of polymetallic nodules. It is a large reservoir of polymetallic nodules. What are these polymetallic nodules? These are nothing but minerals which are in very high demand, like manganese. Then we have nickel. Then we have cobalt and copper. So the ocean bed is full of all these 4 minerals. We call these 4 minerals as polymetallic nodules. First is that important thing. Second important thing is that India has recently got the right for exploring the 75,000, can you imagine, 75,000 square kilometer of ocean bed. Fine. The third important thing is that 95% of the ocean bed is still unexplored. Okay, so first of all, the ocean bed is full of resources, mineral resources, and second, the 95% is unexplored. Third, India has got 75,000 square kilometer of right to explore 75,000 square kilometer of ocean bed. And fourth and very important thing is that the United Nations has declared the decade 2021 to 2030 as the decade for as a decade of ocean science and sustainable development. So this is the United Nations declared decade of ocean science and sustainable development. So these four important things are there, and that's why the India has launched its own deep ocean mission. Now moving forward, now let's see what are the components of deep ocean mission. So see, the deep ocean mission in India is a multi-ministerial, multidisciplinary program with emphasis on, now see what we are required for carrying out the deep ocean mission. The first is the development of deep sea technology. For example, if you are going 6,000 fathom deep in the ocean, so we require a special technology to survive there and to carry out the exploration process. Okay, and then we will explore the deep sea minerals, as I have discussed you, polymetallic nodules and biodiversity. The third important thing is that deep sea observations and capacity building, it is very important for the survival of ocean ecology. And then for carrying out all this purpose, we need to acquire the research vessel for exploration. So these are the benefits, or these are the components of India's deep ocean mission. Now you will imagine that why we are interested, why India is particularly interested in deep ocean mission. So as I have discussed in earlier classes also, that India's coastline is about 75,000 kilometer. 30% of India's population lives in coastal area. So oceans has a profound impact on significant number of India's people. So that's why deep ocean mission is very important for India. Now we will see the major objectives of deep ocean mission. The first is that we are interested in developing the technologies for deep sea mining. Mining किसके लिए कर रहे हैं हम यहाँ पे? Just for the extraction of polymetallic nodules and other resources. Then we will be developing underwater vehicles and underwater body robotics. Then development of ocean climate change advisory services. Now what is this? Let me explain you in short, that ocean is one of the largest carbon sink in the world. Oceans, they have profound impact on climate, but due to climate change, the ocean is also changing. The ocean is getting more acidic. So what are the impact of climate change on ocean and its resources and life? This is going to be studied under this project. Along with that, there will be technological innovations for exploration and conservation of deep sea biodiversity. Okay, if you go 6,000 fathom below, you will see that sunlight never reaches there. Okay, so there the ecology, the energy is derived from the interior of the earth. So there we have a different ecology, different ecosystem. So we are going to study that also. Then deep ocean survey and exploration, we are going to find out what are the different minerals, what are the different topography at the bottom of the sea. Okay, and then we will study the proof of concept studies on energy. If we can derive energy from the ocean bottom are known for energy. Okay, based on interior of the earth, the heat from the interior of the earth is converted into energy. So that one, and then fresh, if we can obtain the fresh water from the ocean through the process of desalination. And then we will be establishing advanced marine station for ocean biology. So these are the important objectives of India's deep ocean mission. Now coming to a question, that which of the following is the nodal implementing agency of the deep sea mission in India? Option A is Ministry of Environment, Forest and Climate Change. Option B is Ministry of Earth Science. Option C is Ministry of Defense. Option D is Ministry of Ports, Shipping and Inland Waterways. And option E is none of the above. So let's move to the correct answer. The correct answer is answer B, Ministry of Earth Science. So Ministry of Earth Science is a nodal agency for the implementation of the deep ocean mission in India. Who is the Minister of Earth Science in India? Please give me the answer in the comment box. That Minister of Earth Science in India is. And yes, along with that, also give me the answer that who is the Union Minister of Health and Family Welfare in India. So please give me two answers. Who is the Union Minister of Earth Science and who is the Union Minister of Health and Family Welfare? Now coming to the Indian Vessels Bill 2021. So Inland Vessels Bill 2021, this bill is related to inland waterways. It is related to inland waterways. Now, inland waterways, India has 4,000 किलोमीटर स्ट्रेच ऑफ इनलैंड वाटरवेज, 4,000 किलोमीटर स्ट्रेच है इंडिया का वाटरवेज के लिए, इनलैंड वाटरवेज के लिए. नाउ व्हाई वी आर एक्सप्लोरिंग इंडिया इनलैंड वाटरवेज, सी ऑलरेडी वी आर इन एन एरिया वेयर क्लाइमेट चेंज इज रियलिटी. हमको क्लाइमेट चेंज से फाइट करने के लिए एक ऐसा मोड ऑफ ट्रांसपोर्टेशन चूज़ करना चाहिए कि जो लेस पॉल्यूटिंग हो, फर्स्ट, सेकेंड, विच इज़ लेस कॉस्टली ऑल्सो. ओके फाइन. सो द इनलैंड वाटरवे, ओके, इट कैन बी हेल्पफुल फॉर इंडिया इन टू वेज. फर्स्ट इज डिक्रीजिंग द पॉल्यूशन, सेकेंड इज एज कम्पेयर टू रोड एंड रेलवे, इट इज अ चीपर मोड ऑफ ट्रांसपोर्टेशन. इट इज द चीपर मोड ऑफ ट्रांसपोर्टेशन. ओके सो दैट्स वाई द 4,000 किलोमीटर स्ट्रेच हैज बिन डिक्लेयर्ड एज इनलैंड वाटरवे इन इंडिया. ओके एंड इंडियन वाटरवे अथॉरिटी ऑफ इंडिया, इट इज हेडक्वार्टर्ड इन नोएडा. वी कॉल्ड इट इंडियन वाटरवे अथॉरिटी ऑफ इंडिया. It is headquartered in Noida. Now, in order to enable the ships and vessels to travel throughout the territory of India, अभी क्या regulation है? That different states have different regulations for regulating the vessels, small small ships, okay, boats. Fine. तो क्या होता है कि महाराष्ट्र के ship they cannot get service in, they cannot do service in other states, okay? So now what this bill is what doing, that it is doing away with the requirement of states regulation and it is creating a pan India regulation so that vessels can move throughout the territory of India freely. So it will replace the Indian Vessels Act 1917. The bill will regulate the safety, security and registration of inland vessels. It will provide, this is very important, it will provide for the unified law for the entire country. Abhi kya hai system, instead of separate rules framed by the states, the certificate of registration granted under the proposed law will be deemed to be valid in all states and union territories. ये सबसे important point है इस bill का. Fine. तो इसके वजह से क्या हो जाएगा? That there will be no need to seek separate permissions from different states. Fine. तो इससे क्या होगा कि one vessel from any state can go in any other states. There is no requirement of registration. Okay. Now coming to the third and very important topic, 8th ASEAN Defence Ministers Meet Plus. It was held virtually recently and it was attended by the India's Defence Minister Shri Rajnath Singh. Okay, fine. So the 8th ASEAN Defence Ministers Meet Plus. What is the meaning of this plus? The meaning of this plus is, apart from 10 ASEAN countries of Southeast Asia, there are other countries also, which are China, Japan, Australia, New Zealand, South Korea, India, Russia and USA. Okay, and USA, and USA is also the part of this 8th ASEAN Defense Ministers Meet Plus. Now what is the objective of this Defense Ministers Meet? So if you will see, the concept is same, that peaceful peace and stability in Indo-Pacific region. Peace and stability in Indo-Pacific region. Okay, fine, because this region is dominated by countries which are growing very fast economically, so peace and stability is required in this region. So the objectives are regional peace and stability through dialogue and cooperation, not through fight. For example, if you have read in the newspaper that recently China sent air forces, okay, fighter planes in Taiwan, near Taiwan, and it did same thing with Philippines last month. So it is not a proper way of resolving the dispute. So what is the proper way of resolving the dispute? It is through dialogue and cooperation. The second thing is to promote mutual trust and confidence through greater transparency and openness. It means that whatever dispute is going on, there should be a transparency that what the both the sides think about the dispute. आगे चलते हैं. Now what is the India is hoping for? So if you will see the South China Sea, South China Sea जो है वो, it is the part of Pacific Ocean and it is the disputed sea. Okay, it is a disputed sea between China on one side, then Philippines, Malaysia, Vietnam, Taiwan on other side, and Brunei also on the other side. Okay, there are certain territories in South China Sea like Partley Islands, Kerbalog Shoals. These are contested by China and other ASEAN countries also. Now, what India is hoping? India is hoping that there will be a code of conduct for South China Sea to be followed by each and every country surrounding that sea. Now, who is negotiating this code of conduct for South China Sea? It is being conducted with ASEAN countries on one side and China on the other side. And now India is hoping that whatever will be the outcome, it will be based on international laws such as United Nations Convention on the Law of the Sea. Okay, third thing which India is hoping is that whatever the decision will be of this code of conduct for South China Sea, the rights of other countries who are not the part of this dialogue, that will also be protected. Okay, now what India supports? India supports utilization of ASEAN led mechanism. It means what? That India directly participate nahi kar raha hai. Okay, India directly ASEAN ke taraf se nahi bol raha hai, but India is supporting that whatever the decision is for the South China Sea, it should be ASEAN led. It should not be, for example, China led. It should not be India led. It should not be US led. It should be ASEAN led mechanism for implementation of shared vision for open Indo-Pacific. Fine. Now Indo-Pacific. Now why this Indo-Pacific is always in the news? Aapne क्वाड के बारे में भी पढ़ा होगा. क्वाड सिक्योरिटी डायलॉग बिटवीन फोर कंट्रीज, इंडिया, ऑस्ट्रेलिया, यूएसए एंड जापान. ओके, सो दिस इज ऑल्सो फोकस्ड ऑन इंडो पैसिफिक. सो वाई इंडो पैसिफिक इज इंपॉर्टेंट, अब हम नेक्स्ट स्लाइड में उसको देखेंगे. सो सी, दिस इज इंडो पैसिफिक रीजन. फाइन, सो दिस इज वेस्टर्न, यू कैन से वेस्टर्न पैसिफिक, सेंट्रल पैसिफिक. Then this is tropical region, this is tropical Indian Ocean. Okay, and see the countries which are surrounding the Indo-Pacific: Japan, South Korea, China, ASEAN, Australia. From here you can say USA, because the western USA, okay, it lies on Pacific coast. Then India, then you can see the Gulf countries which are rich in oil, then Africa, then Madagascar. These are all the regions which are surrounding the Indo-Pacific. Ab isko thoda alag tarike se samjhiye. Fine, what did I say in the last slide? That this region is the fastest growing region including India. Theek hai, first thing. Second, if this region are fastest growing region, they require energy, but they are not rich in energy. Now which region is rich in energy? This region is rich in energy. What it? So what happens that energy, okay, this is the energy surplus region, this one. Okay, this is the energy surplus region and this is the energy deficit region. So the energy flows from here, then from Strait of Malacca to energy deficit region. Now what will happen that if only one country dominates this whole region? So it can happen in the future that other countries, they are not receiving the energy supply from Gulf countries. Okay, first point. Second, trade between these two regions will be carried out along these routes. If somebody blocks this route, for example, here is Strait of Malacca. Okay, if somebody blocks the Strait of Malacca, then goods cannot move from ASEAN region or from Southeast Asia to other regions in Africa, India and Gulf countries. Got it? So the Indo-Pacific region, that's why it has become a very important region in the world. Now coming to Indo-Pacific region. So see, it is the vast maritime zone consisting of tropical Indian Ocean, tropical Western and Central Pacific Ocean. Now see, the term Indo-Pacific, what does it signifies? It signifies the interconnectedness of Indian and Pacific Oceans. Let's go to the diagram back. Okay, here is the Strait of Malacca. Here is your Pacific Ocean, South China Sea, and here is your Indian Ocean. Okay, so these two regions are connected through Strait of Malacca. So the Indo-Pacific region signifies the interconnectedness between Indian Ocean and Pacific Ocean. Okay, and why it has become important? Because of growing Chinese assertiveness. Now the next question is, स्ट्रेट ऑफ मलक्का कनेक्ट्स विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग. ओके, सो ऑप्शन ए इज अरेबियन सी एंड पर्शियन गल्फ, अरेबियन सी एंड रेड सी, अंडमान सी एंड साउथ चाइना सी, अरेबियन सी इन एंड मेडिटेरेनियन सी, नन ऑफ द अबव. लेट्स गो टू द राइट आंसर. इट इज अंडमान सी एंड साउथ चाइना सी. इफ इट कम्स इन एग्जाम इंडियन ओशन एंड पैसिफिक ओशन, देन दैट इज ऑल्सो राइट. सो सी, द स्ट्रेट ऑफ मलक्का कनेक्ट्स अंडमान सी इन इंडियन ओशियन विद साउथ चाइना सी इन पैसिफिक ओशियन. नाउ स्ट्रेट ऑफ मलक्का इज अ वेरी नैरो पॉइंट. ओके, इज अ चोक पॉइंट एंड इट लाइज बिटवीन मलाई पेनिनसुला ऑफ मलेशिया एंड सुमात्रा आइलैंड ऑफ इंडोनेशिया. एंड नाउ व्हाई इट इज इम्पॉर्टेंट, बिकॉज इट इज द मेन शिपिंग लाइन और मेन शिपिंग चैनल बिटवीन इंडियन ओशियन एंड पैसिफिक ओशियन, विच आई हैव एक्सप्लेन्ड यू. एंड सी द इम्पॉर्टेंस. इट इज द सेकेंड लार्जेस्ट ऑयल ट्रेड चोक पॉइंट इन द वर्ल्ड आफ्टर स्ट्रेट ऑफ होर्मुज. नाउ स्ट्रेट ऑफ होर्मुज इज ऑल्सो इम्पॉर्टेंट. इट कनेक्ट्स, स्ट्रेट ऑफ होर्मुज कनेक्ट्स पर्शियन गल्फ एंड गल्फ ऑफ ओमान and Gulf of Oman. Okay, so majority of oil passes through Strait of Hormuz. Chalo, now what India has a strategy to counter Chinese assertiveness in the Indian Ocean region? So security, it is called as Sagar, security and growth for all in the region. It is India's doctrine of maritime cooperation in the Indian Ocean region. What are the vision of Sagar? So see, the first is coastal security and maritime boundary security. Okay, this is the first and most important thing of Sagar. There should be a coastal security and maritime security. Boundary security means what? That no country should take the area of other country. There should not be any territorial dispute. And second is about cooperation, that capacity building through trade and economic cooperation. Third is that whatever problem the region is facing, that should be solved collectively. So collective action to counter piracy, maritime threat and disasters. The fourth is sustainable development through collaboration, and then maritime engagement and dialogue based peaceful resolution. See, dialogue based, it means that it should be based on dialogue. If there is any problem in the region, it should be based on dialogue. The country should not go for face-to-face confrontation, as it was seen between India and China related to Ladakh dispute. Now the RBI recently came up with the report, State of the Economy. Okay, now see the key highlights of the report. Now this report is actually talking about the current economic scenario. Okay, so see the current economic scenario. The first is, the second wave of pandemic has hit the domestic demand. Obviously baat hai that people, they have lost their jobs, there is no jobs, no income. Okay, so jab income nahi hoga to there will be no demand. Okay, so there will be no demand. Fine, the second is that if the economy wants to recover, the speed and scale of vaccination should be very fast. Okay, India kaise recover karega, that totally depends that how the speed and scale of vaccination against COVID-19 is. If you have read the newspaper, then in India till now only 3.5% of the population has been totally vaccinated, means they have taken double dose. Fine, then the third important point is that in India, investment in healthcare, logistics and research is required. That not only producing the vaccine is important, along with the vaccine production, we should invest in healthcare, logistics and research. And then fourth and very important point the RBI has said is that agriculture and contactless services. Contactless services means where the people are not coming in contact with each other, that is called as contactless services. For example, if you are buying something from Amazon or from Zomato, so you are not coming in contact. So agriculture and contactless services or financial services or banking services, okay, they have not shown any decline during the pandemic. The fifth important point is that industrial production and exports have shown the surge. Why industrial production? Because government came up with new schemes like production linked incentive schemes. Then government came with extended credit guarantee line schemes. All these schemes ensured that the industrial production rises. Fine, now there is a question that Vivad Se Vishwas scheme is for which of the following? A, B, C, D, E. करेक्ट आंसर की तरफ चलते हैं। फॉर सेटलिंग पेंडिंग डायरेक्ट टैक्स डिस्प्यूट, ये बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट है, ये न्यूज़ में था। ये न्यूज़ में क्यों था, वो बहुत ही इंटरेस्टिंग है। सी रैशनल इज द डायरेक्ट टैक्स विवाद से विश्वास स्कीम वॉज इंट्रोड्यूस टू सेटल पेंडिंग डायरेक्ट टैक्स कलेक्शंस एंड अनेबल द गवर्नमेंट टू कलेक्ट रेवेन्यूज लॉक्ड अप इन लिटिगेशन। फॉर एग्जाम्पल कि डायरेक्ट टैक्स का नोटिस किसी को आया, इफ समबडी इज नॉट एग्रींग, सपोज द डायरेक्ट टैक्स नोटिस कम्स टू मी एंड आई डोंट एग्री विद द गवर्नमेंट्स एस्टिमेट, देन आई विल फाइल द केस। सो लॉट ऑफ सच केसेज आर पेंडिंग इन द कोर्ट। फाइन, सो गवर्नमेंट केम अप विद अ न्यू स्कीम दैट वॉट एवर इज अ डिस्प्यूट वी कैन सेटल इट थ्रू अ स्कीम। ओके, सो वॉट हैपन दैट मोस्ट ऑफ द डिस्प्यूट विच वॉज लॉक्ड अप दे ऑल गॉट ओपन, दे ऑल गॉट रिजॉल्व एंड द टैक्सेज इट फ्लू टू गवर्नमेंट, इट केम टू गवर्नमेंट। ओके, सो बिकॉज ऑफ डायरेक्ट टैक्स विवाद से विश्वास स्कीम वी विल सी दैट इंडियाज डायरेक्ट टैक्स रिसिप्ट हैज़ इंक्रीज। ओके, इन द फर्स्ट टू एंड द हाफ मंथ ऑफ 2021-22 इट हैज़ ऑलमोस्ट डबल टू रुपीज 1.86 लाख करोड़। फाइन, वॉट इट, सो हाउ इट कैन बी हेल्पफुल फॉर इंडिया। सो सी ऑलरेडी वी आर फेसिंग इकोनॉमिक प्रॉब्लम्स, सो दिस मनी कैन बी यूटिलाइज बाई द गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया फॉर बूस्टिंग द डिमांड इन द इकोनॉमी। ओके, सो दिस इज़ वन ऑफ द गुड न्यूज़। देन द नेक्स्ट न्यूज़ विच इज इम्पॉर्टेंट इज पावर कंजम्पशन इन इंडिया ग्रू बाई 9.3%। नाउ इट मीन्स वॉट, दैट इंडस्ट्रियल प्रोडक्शन इज पिकिंग अप, इंडस्ट्रीज अब काम करना चालू कर दी है, इसीलिए पावर कंजम्पशन इंडिया में बढ़ गया है। सो पावर कंजम्पशन इन इंडिया ग्रू बाई 9.3% इन द फर्स्ट हाफ ऑफ जून 2021। ओके, नाउ वॉट इट इंडिकेट्स, इट इंडिकेट्स स्लो रिकवरी इन कमर्शियल एंड इंडस्ट्रियल इलेक्ट्रिसिटी डिमांड। ओके, सो दिस इज गुड न्यूज फॉर इंडिया दैट वी आर नाउ ऑन द पाथ ऑफ रिकवरी एंड इफ RBI एंड गवर्नमेंट टेक्स अ स्टेप्स इन टैंडम टू इम्प्रूव द इकोनॉमिक सिनेरियो वी कैन इजिली बी एट द प्री कोविड स्टेज ग्रोथ रेट। फाइन, नाउ सी वन बट डिस्टर्बिंग ट्रेंड इज दैट वी आर ऑब्जर्विंग राइट नाउ इज द राइजिंग इन्फ्लेशन। वी हैव ऑब्जर्व दैट द होल सेल प्राइस इंडेक्स हैज़ हिट द 25-year रिकॉर्ड ऑफ नियरली 13%। होलसेल प्राइस इंडेक्स बहुत ज़्यादा बढ़ गया है। ओके, इन लास्ट लेक्चर इफ यू रिमेंबर वी हैड डिस्कस्ड दिस दैट द होलसेल प्राइस इंडेक्स हैड इंक्रीज एंड देयर वाज अ डेंजर दैट CPI कैन ऑल्सो इंक्रीज, बट नाउ द इट हैज़ बिकम अ रियलिटी दैट सी द रिटेल इन्फ्लेशन इज नाउ ऑल्सो एट 6.3%। इफ यू रिमेंबर द टारगेट ऑफ मॉनेटरी पॉलिसी कमिटी, सो द टारगेट इज वॉट 4% प्लस माइनस 2%, इट मीन्स 2% टू 6% के बीच में ही इन्फ्लेशन होना चाहिए, उससे ज़्यादा नहीं होना चाहिए, बट नाउ यू सी इट इज 6.3% मोर देन द टारगेट। नाउ RBI इज ऑलरेडी फॉलोइंग द एकोमोडेटिव पॉलिसी। ओके, इट इज ऑलरेडी फॉलोइंग एकोमोडेटिव पॉलिसी, वी हैव डिस्कस्ड दिस। सो वॉट शुड बी द वॉट कैन बी द RBI पॉलिसी इन द फ्यूचर वी विल लुक फॉर। ओके, बट राइट नाउ सी द रीजन्स फॉर इंक्रीजिंग इन्फ्लेशन, फ्यूल प्राइसेस। ओके, फ्यूल प्राइसेस यहाँ पे क्यों बढ़ रहे हैं, क्योंकि यहाँ पे हमारे एक्साइज ड्यूटीज टैक्सेस बहुत ज़्यादा हैं फ्यूल प्राइसेस के। ओके, हाउ कैन वी रिड्यूस द फ्यूल प्राइसेस, वन ऑफ द सॉल्यूशन इज दैट इफ यू ब्रिंग फ्यूल प्राइसेस इन द एम्बिट ऑफ GST वी कैन रिड्यूस द फ्यूल प्राइसेस इन इंडिया। द सेकेंड इज कि सिर्फ फ्यूल प्राइसेस के साथ साथ इफ यू विल सी द फूड इन्फ्लेशन इज ऑल्सो एट वेरी हाई। सो सी द रिटेल इन्फ्लेशन इन फूड, इट हैज़ हिट द 6-month हाई ऑफ 5%। ओके, हमने पिछले लेक्चर में इसके बारे में बात की थी पिछले वीडियो में कि पॉसिबिलिटी है कि बिकॉज ऑफ दिस सेकेंड कोविड सर्ज इन रूरल एरिया द सप्लाई फ्रॉम रूरल एरिया में नॉट रीच मंडी एंड इट कैन लीड टू स्कैरसिटी ऑफ फूड सप्लाई। वही यहाँ पे हो रहा है, इफ यू विल सी इन अप्रैल इट वॉज 2%, बट जस्ट विद इन 2 months इट हैज़ रिजन टू 5%। ओके, और खास करके दाम किसका बहुत ज़्यादा बढ़ा हुआ है, प्रोटीन फूड्स का, पल्सिस एंड एग्स, इसको हम प्रोटीन इन्फ्लेशन भी कहते हैं, प्रोटीन इन्फ्लेशन। ओके, फाइन, सो वी कॉल इट एज प्रोटीन इन्फ्लेशन। सो प्रोटीन इन्फ्लेशन मीन्स प्रोटीन का, प्रोटीन प्रोडक्ट्स का दाम बढ़ रहा है। ओके, वॉट इज द रीजन बिहाइंड दिस, बिकॉज ऑफ चेंज इन फूड बास्केट ऑफ इंडिया as well as that the cost of edible oils is also increasing because of rise in international prices. Then fuel and light means energy, it has hit 11.6 6%, highest in 9 years. Okay, now coming to this, which of the following is the first country to adopt cryptocurrency as the legal tender? बहुत जल्दी से इसका आंसर दीजिए, न्यूज में था, इट वॉज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. चलिए आंसर की तरफ चलते हैं. सो इट इज एल सेल्वाडोर. एल सेल्वाडोर बिकेम द फर्स्ट कंट्री टू अडॉप्ट क्रिप्टो करेंसी एज द लीगल टेंडर. लीगल टेंडर का मतलब कि गवर्नमेंट ने इसको रिकोगनाइज कर दिया है एंड नाउ इट इज कंपेरेबल विद द फिजिकल करेंसी. हम इंडिया की बात करते हैं, क्या इंडिया ने इसको अलाउ किया है क्रिप्टो करेंसी को? इंडिया ने, फाइन. सो इंडिया हैज प्रपोज्ड अ बिल विच इज कॉल्ड एज ड्राफ्ट क्रिप्टो करेंसी एंड रेगुलेशन ऑफ ऑफिशियल डिजिटल करेंसी बिल 2021. नाउ व्हाट डज दिस बिल प्रपोजेज, ये बहुत ही इंपॉर्टेंट है. इट प्रपोजेज टू क्रिमिनलाइज, नाउ सी द वर्ड क्रिमिनलाइज, ऑल प्राइवेट क्रिप्टो करेंसीज. मीन्स प्राइवेट क्रिप्टो करेंसीज विल नॉट बी अलाउड इन इंडिया, लाइक बिटकॉइन, इट विल नॉट बी अलाउड इन इंडिया. ओके, उसकी ट्रेडिंग और ये सब कुछ भी अलाउ नहीं होगा. क्यों? बिकॉज RBI फियर्स कि फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल कि उसमें स्पेकुलेशन बहुत ज़्यादा होता है, सेकेंड दैट फ्रॉड उसमें बहुत ज़्यादा होता है. ओके, फ्रॉड उसमें बहुत ज़्यादा होता है. सो दिस इज द टू रीजन दैट वाई RBI इज नॉट गोइंग विद प्राइवेट क्रिप्टो करेंसी. बट RBI इज ओपन टू डिजिटल करेंसी, बट दैट करेंसी विल बी RBI इज ओन. ओके, सो दिस बिल ऑल्सो लेज डाउन द रेगुलेटरी स्टैंडर्ड्स फॉर रेगुलेटरी फ्रेमवर्क फॉर RBI बैक्ड डिजिटल करेंसी. सो ऐसा नहीं है कि इंडिया में डिजिटल करेंसी नहीं होगा, होगा, बट इट विल बी बैक्ड बाई RBI. ओके, इट विल नॉट बी प्राइवेट क्रिप्टो करेंसीज. देन दिस इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. हु अमॉन्ग द फॉलोइंग वॉज इलेक्टेड एज अ न्यू प्राइम मिनिस्टर ऑफ इसराइल एज ऑन 17th June 2021? नफ्ताली बेनेट, येर लैपिड, बेंजामिन नेतन्याहू, रूवेन रिवलिन और नन ऑफ द अबव. So that's the correct answer. It is Naftali Bennett. Okay, so see the rationale. Naftali Bennett of the Yamina party, he allied with Yair Lapid of Yesh Atid party. Okay, they are from two different parties. Okay, so they formed a coalition. Okay, the Yamina party, Naftali Bennett with Yair Lapid and other six parties. Total 8 party government has been formed. Now this 8 party government has ousted the former prime minister Benjamin Netanyahu. Fine, and there is one deal between them that after 2 years serving as prime minister, Naftali Bennett will give way for Yair Lapid to become the prime minister of Israel. So this is also important. Fine, so if you will just see this, so Naftali Bennett is the current PM, Yair Lapid will become PM after 2 years, Benjamin Netanyahu, he was the former prime minister who has been ousted by the coalition between Naftali Bennett and Yair Lapid. Reuven Rivlin is the president of Israel. Now one thing you should know about the Israeli parliament is that the name of the Israeli parliament is Knesset. It is called as Knesset. Okay, and the parliamentary form of government in Israel is not based on first past the post system. First past the post system. Okay, there are two types of system, first past the post system and proportional representation. So first past the post system means any candidate who wins as compared to other candidates, that candidate will be declared as the winner. This system is followed in India. Okay, but in Israel proportional representation is followed. So what happens over there is that if any party, all the parties who are scoring more than 3.5% of the vote polled, okay, so based on the proportion of votes they have got, they will get seats in Knesset. Okay, so the total 120 seats in Knesset will be divided among parties based on the proportion of vote they have received in the electoral poll. So, and the cutoff, the electoral cutoff is 3.5%. Only those parties will be considered for getting the seat in Knesset, those who have got more than 3.5% vote. Okay, so this is called as electoral cutoff. Got it? So these are the some important points. Now AY.1. So AY.1, it was in news. It is a new type of variant which has emerged in India and it has been formally recognized in India. So we have already discussed about B.1.617. Okay, a variant found in India. It is a double mutant variant. Now it has three sub variants. First is B.1.617.1, then B.1.617.2, then B.1.617.3. Out of this, B.1.617.2 has been named as Delta variant. It has been named by Delta variant by WHO. Delta variant. It has been named as Delta variant. Delta variant by WHO. Okay. Now this variant has one more mutation which is called as B.1.617.2.1 or a new name AY.1. Now this variant has a mutation called as K417N. Now what is the problem with K417N? High infectivity. Okay, and it is associated with South Africa. This mutation was also found earlier in South African variant, which is B.1.315. Okay, fine. So it was found in South African variant also. Fine. So this mutation has now come in the Delta variant also. Now see, the evidence of AY.1 has been found in Andhra Pradesh, Maharashtra, Telangana and Karnataka. Okay, so fine, and Karnataka. Now see one more problem with K4171, that some studies have found that K417N, okay, it is associated with resistance to a newly developed monoclonal antibody treatment. Okay, monoclonal antibody treatment drug. Okay, we mix two cocktail and that cocktail drug has to be taken to avoid serious COVID-19 disease. So now, but this K417N mutation of COVID-19 has developed a resistance to this drug cocktail. This drug cocktail is made of two drug, casirivimab and imdevimab. Okay, casirivimab and imdevimab. Fine. So this is one of the danger which is right now going on, that is already showing the resistance to drug cocktail. Okay, so my friends, before I conclude, we have already started with 1 and 2 year courses. You can contact us at 9971444 and you can inquire more about the batches for 2022 and 2023 at our website. You can enroll for the 15-day free trial. Along with that, you can please subscribe to our Telegram channel. The link has been given in our description box for daily questions on English, reasoning, legal knowledge, legal aptitude, general knowledge, maths, quantitative aptitude. So please subscribe us and enrich your knowledge on continuous basis. Thank you.